Hello. So till now we have seen all the advantages and disadvantages of oral communication. So now it's the time to sum up what we have learned in the previous two sessions. We got to know that oral communication is a very popular form of communication both in the personal field as well as in the business field. And of course, it has its own advantages and disadvantages. So first we will sum up all the advantages we have learned. It is time saving. When repetition is necessary, it is the best way to send a message orally. On the other hand, handwritten communication takes a long time to reach the sender. But oral communication through telephone calls or conversations with the subordinates makes savings of time, which is so important in the business world. Next comes reliability, trustworthy. It is true that employees feel more secure when they communicate through oral communication because it has two greatest advantages. It can provide immediate feedback and clarification. Then, flexibility. Oral communication enjoys the benefits of flexibility. Any communication, if written once, you cannot change it so quickly. And if already a written message is sent, then there is very less scope of changing the message. But oral communication can be changed, can be adjusted. So it has flexibility. Then we have already discussed that what? Reduction of cost. It is not expensive. Why it is not expensive? Can you tell me? It has no expenditure in the collection on maintenance of pens, papers, typewriters, computers, or any other materials. Those are required for written communication. Thus, it is time saving also. It is money saving also. And we have already discussed some other that it is good for illiterate person because those who cannot read and write, oral communication is far important. It is far more beneficial to convey messages. And regarding coordination, an organization to attain its goals requires full coordination of all departments or divisions. So such coordination is only possible through oral communication because it can quickly instruct, advise, or motivate the employees as required by the situation. The last comes motivation. Superiors and subordinates can sit face to face and exchange their views directly. This kind of arrangement, motivates and inspires the employees to work with more efficiency. So it helps in motivation. So these are some of the advantages. Now let us go to the disadvantages. The first thing is that what? No record. In oral communication, messages are not preserved and hence they are not found in any kind of record book. So this, since it is not recorded, there is no question of retrieving also in the future. Then oral communication causes lots of misunderstanding. Because due to the limitation of human memory, oral messages cannot be kept in the mind for a longer period of time. And moreover, there is the factor of inattentiveness. So if you hear the message in part, what will happen? The message will get misunderstood. Then same thing, distorted meaning. As oral messages are not filed, their meanings may be easily distorted. And what will this distortion cause? It will cause to rumors. And rumors moves very fast, faster than wind. And lack of accuracy, there is every possibility of an inaccurate message to reach the destination. It may be because of the various barriers, or it may be that the receiver had forgotten some part of the messages and he will spread only some part of the messages, and that could lead to inaccuracy of messages. no legal validity because oral messages are not kept in record. So easily it can be denied by the speaker if the situation goes against him. Then comes leakage of secret information. But oral communication is good for secret information that we have already discussed earlier. But there is also the chance that the speaker might leak the information. So secret information leakage is very much possible in oral communication. Then late decision. Why late decision? Because speaker requires spending much time on discussion and explanation, and as a result, decision making process might get delayed. Then it is said to be less effective in some cases because oral messages carries less weight than written messages. In certain cases like programs, policies, instructions, oral communication is less effective. So these are some of the advantages and disadvantages of oral communication. Thank you.